straight from the TMZ newsroom and a car in St. Louis, Missouri. It's the Hollywood Beatdown, UFC superstar Tyron Woodley. Tyron, how you doing, man?
I'm out here in this bipolar-ass weather. I got here, it was 24 degrees on Sunday, snowing. Then it was a rainstorm and I tried to fly out of here. And then yesterday it was 85 degrees and today it is raining. So I think we had every single climate in one week.
There's a lot of crazy stuff going on, man. There's a lot of crazy UFC stuff. There's a lot of crazy boxing stuff. And there's some beef with the UFC fighter that doesn't involve you. It involves me. And we're going to get to that right now and Fired Up. All right, I know we always start with Fired Up, and it's about, you know, what you're upset about, but I got to tell you, I'm fired up this week. And
there we go. I like that.
We got to talk about Brendan Schaub, who I like, by the way, who's been in the office. He's hosted TMZ Sports before. I like him. I think he's a good dude. But he went on the Joe Rogan podcast this week, and he said some stuff that's just wrong, and I feel like we got to call him out for it and set him straight. I want to set up the situation first before we play you all of the audio. A couple of weeks ago, I interviewed Jon Jones while he got ready for his fight. And I said, look, man, you're back in the UFC. You got, you know, a lot of people want to fight Jon Jones. Is there anybody that you are interested in fighting?
Israel Adesanya.
Yeah.
And he's only a middleweight, but, I mean, it doesn't take long to get up to light heavyweight as a middleweight. Get to eat a little bit more comfortably and not cut weight. I got a feeling me and him will eventually fight each other. I think the fans will want that eventually.
Right, then we spoke with Israel Adesanya about a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, before his fight, UFC 236, said, look, man, Jon Jones said that a fight with you was something that he would be interested in. How do you feel about that?
I like challenges. So he's the GOAT right now, right? I already killed one GOAT. I'm hunting the next.
All right, so then fast forward to the Joe Rogan podcast, which, again, one of my favorite podcasts. I listen to it almost every single day. He's great. But Brendan Schaub goes on the podcast, and he makes this comment about us, suggesting that there was like a diabolical plot the whole time. Take a look.
Talking to 183-pounder is kind of silly.
Yeah, but if you say that in an interview, I don't think that's that disrespectful.
I don't either.
The way he said it is that one day maybe we're going to fight.
Yeah, but then Stylebender, you know, TMZ asked him. They don't know shit about fighting. They're like, oh, this guy's big. They're both black. Let's fight. They have no idea. Yeah. You know, that's what they think.
First off, I'm not trying to pretend that I'm Joe Rogan or Brendan Schaub. I'm not trying to be a UFC technical expert like they are. I'm not, right? I'm a fan who talks to people like Tyron Woodley. I get the honor of talking to people like Tyron Woodley and other UFC fighters who come here all the time, and I try to ask them questions from the fan's perspective. I'm not trying to be the expert. But for him to say that, I feel like it's wrong, number one. It's disrespectful, number two. And I think that, you know, I feel like, honestly, he owes us an apology for that.
All right, well, I'm going to jump in real quick because you are fired up because you just went straight through.
I am fired up.
And the thing is, I don't think you fired up enough, so I'm going to have to instigate it. You like too nice with the fired up. I love Joe Rogan show. I like Brendan Schaub. We had him in here. To say that TMZ don't know nothing was never thought that TMZ, every employee, a part of their curriculum or part of their requirements is that they had to be a black belt in jiu-jitsu, MMA fights, at least 7 pro fights on your record, or you can't work there. The job is to report, whether it's good, bad, drama, politics, whatever, to give you it as fast as you can, the knowledge, with, you know, good credibility. Am I right?
Right. That's right.
So if you have the person sitting there, you're giving him an opportunity to potentially fight one of the greatest fighters of all time. Right. Israel Adesanya should thank you. Now, because of that video, he replied, I knocked out one goat. I'm ready to check out another one. Then Jon Jones gave him the opportunity again, which he kind of dropped the ball. I'm not going to be bullied. You just said you're going to kill another goat.
Right. So
Jon gave him another opportunity to yet again be more relevant after you just won an interim title. Great fight. One of the best fights I've seen in a long time. And the fucking greatest fighter of all time calls you out. This is great. This is a sport.
Yeah.
Our sport is marketed and is actually promoted off drama. I think it was low-key almost not calling you guys racist, but saying that all you guys just want to see two black people going at it. As if you don't really care if they're good, if they got skill, technique. You just want to see two muscle-bound black dudes beat each other's ass. I would take it more like that. I would take the shot even more personal because it's almost saying that you guys at TMZ don't know anything. You guys are racist. Damn!
Well, hey, look, it's offensive, but like, I'm not trying to like declare war on Brendan Schaub. I'm really not. What I'd rather do is, if Brendan Schaub was watching this and you want to come into the office and talk this thing out, come on in. I got whiskey at my desk.
No,
we can have a drink.
You know
we can talk this out. What do you mean?
No. That shit didn't sound gangster at all. Well, we're gonna.
I'm not trying to be gangster. Hey, I'm trying to be an adult.
One time when I told you we got to pull up to the club and you got to show me that you got my back, and we got to get into a fight. It might be time.
You're a better fighter than I am.
It might be time. You know, Brandon ain't fought in a long time. You know what I mean? He's been modeling and at red carpets and doing podcasts and stand-up comedy. You know what I mean? So I think it's time. You've been running.
I'm not fighting Brandon Schaub, but I would like to talk to Brandon Schaub. All right, moving on to Tyron's favorite segment is called...
Hey, on the real, though.
On the real, we got to talk about Clarissa Shields. She, in my opinion, is the greatest living female fighter on the planet. She beat the crap out of Christina Hammerd this last weekend. She's dominating people. I spoke with her yesterday, and I asked her, I go, you got a problem because you are so much better than every other female boxer that you have faced and is even out there. So what are you going to do next? And she told me...
MMA.
She's dead serious. No, not MMA. She wants to fight men.
They always say, oh, you know, a woman can't beat a man. I spar with men. And, I mean, I drop men. I bust men nose. I beat men up all the time. I think I can beat up Keith Thurman.
Really?
I really do. I think I can beat up Keith Thurman, even though, you know, they're like, oh, you know, he beat Sean Porter. I think I can beat Sean Porter, too. Triple G, he's older now, but I can give Triple G a run for his money.
Do you think a person like Clarissa can honestly hold her own and compete against a champion boxer like Keith Thurman?
I'm not going to say a champion boxer, but I know her. I connected her with Dean, my coach, because she told me she wanted to do MMA. So obviously, even before you guys mentioned the fact that she don't have that much competition from females, she was already thinking of different ways to challenge herself, and I think that's what sets her apart. I do think she can hang with a professional boxer. I'm not going to say world champion, and I'm also not going to discredit her and say she can't. But I think confidently, to put my name and signature underneath it, I think there is some professional fighters around her way she can probably get a business to.
Men.
Yeah, I think so.
How does this happen? Because she wants it to happen. She was very serious about that. She's like, this is not a joke.
I don't think a commission is going to do that. I mean, sometimes, you know, back in the day when Cyborg was running through every woman, it almost looked like they kept sending out different sacrificial lambs with different color hair.
Right.
It was like, it was kind of horrible to watch. She was like really fucking them up. So at that time, we were thinking that, dude, she can beat some fucking guys. And then people, maybe one or two people said Ronda Rousey maybe could have been a guy. If she, you know, if he had terrible hands and no jiu-jitsu and she threw him on his fucking head, she might be able to break his arm. I don't agree with it. I think she can find different ways to challenge herself.
Do you think there's a possibility she could go somewhere like Japan or Thailand and get an exhibition fight with a guy, like a 3-round fight with maybe somebody?
Unfortunately, she'd be able to get some bare knuckle shit if she could go deep enough in the bush.
You don't want to see that.
No, I want to see her keep dominating. I'm a big fan. She a beast. I want to see her keep.
I do too.
I want to see when you get to the, like I said this, and don't steal my shit. If y'all watch this and you hear it later on in the rap, do not try to steal my bar. I think that she's ran out of opponents, and now her opponents is just different sets of mirrors. She's going to start having themes in fights where it's not about winning a fight. This fight, I want to work on my cross to the body. This fight, I want to try to knock somebody out with a left foot. This fight, I want to try to stop the person in the first round. That's going to become her new challenge and her new competition. Is, you know, it's going to get to the point where you're competing against yourself. You're competing against your last performance. Eventually, if she keeps working hard, if she can get better, if she stays the way she is, she's going to be at the top for a long time. But if she gets better continue to get better, we're talking about 8-9 years of this shit if she wants to. So at that point, she might consider fighting a male. I just don't know any commission in the States that's going to clear that.
Now it's the part of the show where Tyron gets to pat somebody on the back and punch somebody else in the face. So Tyron, who are you going to be nice to this week?
See, you couldn't even get it out because you knew for a fact that I might not be nice this week. First off, I'm going to start with the good news first. The good news is Wiz Khalifa, my man, you get the pat on the back today. I watched behind the cam. This is special on Apple Music or Apple Digital where you can download it. He has video of third grade rapping. His dad, you know, starting a studio. He was rapping in front of 3 people for like 50 minutes. He had an autograph signing and one person came in the whole 2-hour block. So just to stay with it, I watched that and I already have respect. You know we homies. But when I watched that, I got a different layer of respect for him. Now for the bad news, I'm normally the puncher, but I'm in a great mood right now. So therefore, I'm going to let you punch somebody this week. And we're going to make it Brandon Schaub.
You want me to punch Brandon Schaub, but I don't want to punch Brandon Schaub.
If you guys are watching Facebook, slide over to YouTube. If you guys are watching on YouTube, subscribe to TMZ Sports. Either way, go. Go to YouTube and subscribe to TMZ Sports.
And hey, Brandon Schaub, if you're watching this, I got the whiskey if you got the time. I'll see you next week.